Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue March Madness here at BusyWorksBeats.com, where we're giving you free videos on the YouTube page to let you see the type of videos we put up in the premium section at BusyWorksBeats.com for the month of March only. So it's just to give you a window as to what goes on. Now there's much more in the premium section, like placement opportunities, sound downloads, drum kits, project files, and special offers and articles. So there's much more than just video. If you're wondering, you know, we upload the same videos to YouTube to the premium section so that you don't have to switch back and forth to YouTube. So if you see a similar video and wonder why you're seeing the same YouTube video on the premium section, it's because we don't want you to have to switch back and forth. So you will see similar video titles. Does that mean it's the same as YouTube? Absolutely not. We have over 400 unique videos in premium alone versus YouTube. So there's much more content for you. So just to clear that up. So anyway, today we're going to go over and continue the plugin exploration, where you may have forgotten about these plugins and plugins you may not have and you just want to learn about them. So this is not a tutorial about Massive. Okay, we're just going to build a sound in Massive, go over a couple features, and just reintroduce Massive to you. So first, I like to go to File, New Sound, so it resets all the filters and all the knobs for me. Okay, so that's one. Now the type of sound I'm going to build today is going to be some type of bass sound, because bass, we can add a lot of texture to it without it being overly done. So let's start with a low octave. So I'm not going to go through everything about sound design here. So if you want to follow along, so be it. The main pitch, we're going to drop that down 2 octaves, negative 24. Every 12 semitones is an octave. So we're doing it in multiples of 12. So negative 24 would mean we're going down 2 octaves. So we get a nice bass patch. Now here it shows us the waveforms. It's a square slash saw. In the wavetable position, if you've seen Serum, you see the wave shape change over time. So if I move this knob, it goes from a saw to a square. And you can modulate that if you'd like. Let's just keep it on a sawtooth for now. And what I want to do is add a sine wave. So let's click here so we can choose from the list of waveforms. Let's click on sine. Now right here it says sine square. So when this is to the right, it's square. So I'm going to switch it to a sine. So it's more pure of a tone. Now I'm going to pitch this one up, actually, 12 semitones. Just to have contrast between low and high frequency. Now I'm not going to let it play at a high volume, so let's turn down the amp. I just want it to be an overtone. Something you can barely tell. So here's without. It's a color tone. It's there for just making the tone more unique. And let's go down here to... Now one thing you could do is turn on your ring mods or your modulation oscillator. So anyway, you can modulate different waveforms. Without digging into what modulation is, let's turn off oscillator 1. You hear this high frequency? We can modulate that by the RM oscillator. So we can modulate oscillator 2 by the ring mod. As I turn this up, it will transform the tonality of the sound. What we can do here is lower the pitch of the ring mod in intervals of 12. And if I lower the pitch here, we get kind of that scrapey, it's hard to describe the sound, but it's just the FM sound, scraping those harmonics. Okay, if we go lower, you might get a little more clarity as to what's going on, so let's lower it down. You see it becomes more bubbly. Now I'm assuming the RM here is more of a sine wave modulation. In different plugins, you can change the type of RM. So I'm adding that customized tone as a color tone. That's just more uniqueness. That's just to make my sound separate from somebody else's. Let's add some white noise to, again, add more uniqueness to our sound by turning the amplitude up. Now the color determines how bright the tone is for the noise. I'm going to lower it so that it's not as high frequency. adding a low-pass filter to the noise. So it's very, like, windy sounding. Now, one thing I want to do is send oscillator 1 through a filter because it's too buzzy. It's too upfront. Let's move this tab to F1, which stands for filter 1. Let's click here. Let's change that to a low-pass 4 dB per octave. Turn down the resonance. And if I mute all the other sounds here, I'm just cutting out the brightness, the bitiness of this tone, making it a little more controllable. Let's activate the oscillators, and now we have a little more color. So I like using white noise to texturize sounds. It's how I make my sound sound different than everybody else, and it adds a realistic sound to it somewhat. Now let's go down here to the bottom tabs. These are like effects. I like to think of them. Let's go to Bit Crusher. Bit Crusher is known to add higher frequencies. I don't really like that sound, so let's go to Sine Shaper instead. Similar to modulation, RM or FM. Basically similar. Let's try adding a little distortion here. Just for, again, texture and tone. We don't really have to do much. I mean, unless you want to modulate things, meaning move things over time. Let's go to voices. Let's try two voices. I don't like to turn up my voices a lot for bass. Let's activate the unison spread. Turn up the pitch cutoff. So it's now a detuned bass sound. Turn down the noise because it's getting a little cluttered. Also turn down the distortion. This is basically the pitch relationship between the two voices. Then we can do pan position, so let's turn that on. I'm going to make it full stereo. So one's pan left, one's pan right. If it were mono, everything would be pan dead center. And you have phase issues which can occur. Now we have them spread. One thing I want to do is make the resonance move. So let's turn up the resonance so we can hear what's going on. You can hear it adds that kind of metallic bite. So I want to give that modulation. So I'm going to add an LFO to control the resonance here. Let's turn it up to its max amount. It's actually a pretty cool sound how it's kind of on and off. The only thing is I don't want it to restart. Or you know what, it may be the shape that's creating that sound. So I don't use the LFOs on here very much, so it's a little awkward getting used to the which one is which. So I think it was blending a sine wave with a sawtooth. So now it's just a sine wave motion for the LFO. I like that sound. Let's just lower the rate a bit. I'm going to sync it to the tempo. And let's go 4/1, meaning every 4 bars it will move. So we get a nice unique sound. One more thing I want to do is make it bigger and atmospheric. Let's add some effects like reverb to make it feel like it's in a big environment. With reverb, the only thing about this reverb is I want to cut out the lows. I'm assuming that's what the color knob is for. So now we have a nice long tail. But I'd like to go to EQ. Let's cut out some things if we can. Let's turn that low shelf down. But again, that messes with the whole sound. I just want to EQ the reverb. This is why I like to do processing outside of plugins sometimes. So what I'm going to do is open up the mixer, load up a reverb so that I can control the low frequency content in the reverb. So I'm going to cut out the lows. Give it a nice decay time. So we still have our bass sound, but we don't have bass in the reverb, which is different. Now we have a cool like movie or video game sound. Like Rainbow Six, some kind of shooting game, but not Call of Duty. So it just goes to show that a lot of the synthesizers can do similar things. It's just about learning the fundamentals. You can get started with the fundamentals of sound design at busyworksbeats.com. /sounddesign. And we're just continuing the plugin exploration series here today, where we go through plugins you may have forgotten about or plugins that you haven't experienced yet. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.